last month there was a question about whether or not a certain modifier was allowed on a CPT code for Medicare. And the way that I found that, I kind of went through real quickly and said, oh, here's where I find it on the Medicare website. And somebody said, wait, can you back up and actually, like, give us the step-by-step of how we get there? And it's funny, you take for granted those things that you're used to using day in and day out. So I did. I put together kind of a step-by-step process here. And step one kind of tells you to start at the physician fee schedule lookup, and I've included the link directly to that. If you, for some reason, don't have that link and you're trying to get there, just go to the CMS.gov website, and there's a small search engine up in the corner right there, and you can just type in physician fee schedule 2016, okay, and that'll get you to the same screen that I'm on. Okay, so that's step one, and I put a screenshot in there for you. Step two is that on that same screen, we are going to click the Start Search button, which is orange, and it's in the middle of the screen. And down at the bottom, Lorene, can you go back to there? Yep. If you scroll up just a little bit.
Up higher than this?
I want you to scroll. I guess I want you to scroll down. I'm thinking about how I move my.
Okay.
Sorry. Right there next to the computer, that search button is what we will click here in just a second. But what I want to point out here is down at the bottom, there is a help PDF file. That PDF file is actually kind of a little booklet that will walk you through how to use this tool, what the different pieces mean, all of that thing. That's where I found a lot of the information that I included in this question for the webinar. But if you were to click Start Search here, then what it's going to do is it's going to pop up a screen that says, hey, you've got to accept the CPT agreement, right, because they're using CPT codes. And then it's going to ask you to put in your search criteria. Well, ideally what we would do is in the search, the selected year, we would put in the current year, which would be 2016. However, if you're to click that drop-down, you're going to find out that we're so early in the year. Right, we haven't had that adjustment to the physician fee schedule yet, so instead of listing it as 2016, it's listed as 2015B. That's the most current version that we have right now. Okay, so you would click on that, and then you're going to select what type of information do you want to get. Do we want pricing information? Do we want payment policy indicators, relative value units, cost indices? What are you looking for? If you're looking for anything around global days, or you're looking for anything around modifiers, you want that payment policy indicators, because that's what is going to give you that information. It's things that's going to affect potential payment for that procedure. So we would have clicked that. Then you can search by a single Hickspicks code. Remember when we say Hickspicks, Hickspicks codes include CPT. CPT is considered level 1 Hickspicks codes, and our little Hickspicks book are level 2 Hickspicks codes. So that's why they say Hickspicks and not CPT. Don't let that throw you off. You'll click that, and you can either search for a single CPT or Hickspicks code, or you can give them a list, or you can give them a range. Maybe you want all of the cardiac casts that are in the same section, or you want a specific code. You would click that single Hickspicks code. Then you can select if you want information from the specific carrier for the state that you're in or the region that you're working in. I always leave it at all carriers because I'm usually doing work in different parts of the country. And then you put in your Hickspicks code, whatever it may be. Can you flip back over to my answer sheet, please? Thank you. And then if you'll scroll down, you'll see I did a sample search and I used a 28043. And 28043 is an excision of a soft tissue tumor in the foot or toe that's less than a half a centimeter, and it's a subcutaneous. That's why it's in the 20,000 series and not the integumentary system. It's back in musculoskeletal. So I kind of included that descriptor there for you. And then under modifier down here, I clicked all modifiers because I want information on all the modifiers for that code. So let's say maybe I was looking to see, well, can I bill an assistant at surgery modifier for this? So I clicked that all modifiers. You can pick just specific ones or you can click all. I always do all. You hit submit. And it's going to pop up this screen for you that says, here's the code that you asked me about. Up at the top is all of the criteria that I put in. And then as you scroll down, you're going to find that they gave me a whole lot of information. Okay. It's not giving me the information I wanted, though. Which one did I clicked a wrong button somewhere. Oh, and here I am trying to click on your screen, Lorene.
You can. I did give you permission if you want to.
No, that's okay. I had payment policy indicators. Is that what you clicked, or did you click? Did you change it, or did you leave it at Yeah, it's pricing information. There we go. Change that one to payment policy. Sorry about that. And hit update.
I'm not a good Vanna White.
That's okay. We're just revealing our secret that I'm not right. Okay. So they don't give you the actual modifier. They do rely on you knowing what the modifier is, like knowing that the bilateral surgery modifier would be your 50 modifier, right? They don't go out and tell you it's a modifier 50. But across here, you'll see that there's a numerical value in each one of those fields. If you had opened that PDF document, that help file, which is actually, again, down at the bottom, buried in there toward the very bottom, it tells you what each of those mean. That is actually the same, most of them have the same meaning that the CCI edits do. So if you're familiar with the CCI edits, you would very quickly, well, that's a different file. Hold on. That's not the one I found yesterday.
Oh, that's the search help.
Yeah, there's another one that's there, how to use that fee schedule booklet.
Yeah, what all these mean up here, okay.
And when you go to that, you know, what everything means, and I will put a link to that in this answer sheet as well, what you would very quickly figure out is it says, okay, down under the modifiers, it tells you, okay, well, if it's, let's say, the bilateral surgery modifier. If it's a zero, it means there's 150% payment adjustment for bilateral procedures that does not apply in this situation. So they don't use that. If it's got a one, it says, oh, that does apply, that 150, right, that they adjust and you only get half of the second procedure. And then if it's a two, it tells you, well, that adjustment doesn't apply in that situation, and here's why. They give you all of this information. Yeah, that's the booklet that I was talking about. As you scroll through that booklet, it actually explains what everything means, not just how to use the searches, but when I click payment pricing, you know, I have pricing information, what's that include? Policy indicators, what's that include? So that you can figure out which searches you need without having to kind of, you know, trial and error. And then as you go farther down in it, it explains what each one of the results means individually. So, you know, bilateral surgery, does it have a zero? Does it have a one? Does it have a two? Here's what those mean.
Very cool.
It's very large. It goes on. But we'll include that link in the answer sheet.
It's amazing what you learn when you read the instructions.
I know, right?
Well, that's... I'm going to really date myself, but way back in the day, that's how I finally figured out that Hickspicks means just what you explained in the beginning, that it includes CPT. Because I could never understand why, when I ran my rehab practice, I would get these memoranda that would talk about Hickspicks, and they would start referring to CPT codes. Then I finally read the beginning of the Hickspicks manual and explained it. It's like, oh, see, I got to read this more.
It's one thing I always stress, and it's funny, I actually, you know, when teaching students in the past, one of the first questions I'd ask on my study guide is, what are Hickspicks Level 1 codes? Because nobody really thinks about it. The Hickspicks says Level 2, but nobody goes, well, what's Level 1? And that's where you find out if they know that that's CPT or not. And that, it makes a big impact when you start dealing with some of the carrier-specific stuff, just like you said.
Do you need more medical certification training? Go to www.cco.us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates.